We rolling, Bob? Hey, we're down in Carolina, we back in the hill. Live my papa daddy in the head of my steel. He brewed white lightning until the sun went down. He pulled out a jug and passes around. Mighty, mighty pleasing, my pappy's corn squeezing. Shoo! White lightning, G-Man, G-Man, revenue's too. Searching for a place where he made his brew. Hey, they were looking, trying to book him, but my pappy kept the cooking. Shoo! White lightning! That's what this song is, man. I mean, the show.
Mm-hmm.
It's white lightning. To the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, we've sent the limo for you. It's pulling up just outside the door to your mind in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. How y'all doing? That's not real important, how y'all doing. Well, it's a little bit important. What is more important that we talk on the show about is, what are y'all doing?
What y'all doing?
Do you really know what y'all are doing? Because we do. And you know what, Ma? We're usurping the first law of nature. I just found out that this week. Do you know what the first law of nature is, Ma?
What is it, Dad?
Self-preservation.
Eat or be eaten.
Reminds me of American Israel. That's what their belief system is, self-preservation.
Mm-hmm.
It's not, they're wrong, right? If it was self-preservation, why would people have purpose and meanings that where they give themselves and give up their life?
I know.
Huh? Yeah. Why would that be? I'll tell you why, Ma, because the first law of nature is to evolve. Your brain is trying to evolve. That's the first law of nature. It's trying to evolve yourself, your brain, your DNA, as in family, tribe, and species. And if you cooperate, that's the secret to happiness and health.
I would like to argue the first law of nature with you, Dad.
That's good. I want all the people to argue all they can because that makes me look real good.
I think the first law of nature would make more sense as everything is connected. Second law, everything is trying to evolve. What do you think about that?
You know. You're right, but everything is connected is in door number 3. It's a little further down the line.
Don't you think that would be the first law?
No, you're going to confuse people so much. They can't even get this first one.
Okay.
You throw that in and holy crap. On this one, they're going to be talking for 100 years, and the science is so corrupt,
mm-hmm.
It'll never get done.
No.
So it's up to us to take it straight to mental health.
Take it straight to Nashville.
Well, I asked my pappy daddy why he had a steal. Okay, what are we kicking the show off with tonight? Everybody's in the limo. Everybody's ready to go.
I can't stop loving you.
Okay, Jimmy Joe's your driver, and we're going to start time traveling. We all do all kinds of traveling.
To 1962.
Well, I got this jammed up really nice. Oh, there. Got it.
You're just angry.
Yeah, I'm getting a little angry because it seems to be taking me a long time to get going here.
It's the electricity.
We're all trying to evolve. You know, for years they've been telling old people, do your crossword puzzles, do your crossword puzzles. They just discovered, the highest stressor of the human brain, which we knew from Henry Ford's factories.
Yes.
Highest stressor of the human brain, boredom.
Yes.
Why do you think it's boredom?
Because
that is the polar opposite of your brain evolving. Your brain is obsessed with evolving. You cut it off, it'll shit all over you
in
brain chemistry.
It'll shit all over you.
What was it again?
I can't stop loving you.
Ray Charles. Hey, wait a minute. Is this Jill's uncle song?
Yep.
Yeah. little old girlfriend of mine, Jill Gibson, we were dancing one night. And I was singing this song. I had it on the record player. And she said, "You know, my uncle wrote that song." And I just about shit myself. Her uncle was Don Gibson. He had the first hit out of it. But then Ray got a hold of it and made some serious dough.
No, Ray.
I can't stop loving you. I said I made up my mind to live in memory of a lonesome time. I can't stop wanting you. Oh, it's just useless to say. So I'll just live my life in dreams of yesterday.
Dreams of yesterday.
Those happy hours.
Those happy hours. That we once knew.
So long ago.
So long ago.
Still make me blue.
Still make me blue.
Oh, they say the time.
They say the time.
They heal a broken heart.
Heals a broken heart.
Yeah, but the time is just steep. And band apart. Now I can't stop loving you. I said I made up my mind to live in memory of a lonesome time. I can't stop wanting you. Oh, it's just useless to say. So I'll just live my life dreams of yesterday.
Dreams of yesterday.
Oh, yesterday. All my troubles seem so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Cause I believe in Merle Haggard. Today I started loving you again. Now I'm right back where I really always been. I got over you just long enough to let my heart in me. And then today I started loving you again.
Yeah, today I started loving you again.
Oh, what a fool I was to think I could get back. The only few million tears I cried. Oh, how was I to know the worst was yet to come? And that bad time for me had just begun. And today I started loving you again. I'm right back where I really always been. I got over you just long enough to let my heart in me. And then today I started loving you again. And then today I started loving you again. Yep. I think it's important to know the big picture of why, you know, what you're doing here on this planet.
Yes.
And did you know it's the same for all 8 billion? It's a common purpose and meaning of life.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Do you think it might be better if you and 8 billion others actually knew so you could do things like checking to see if you are doing it right? No, you could go on down to Israel and go on in there, get Netanyahu and buy done. He's done, you know.
Is he done?
Yeah. Old Joe's all by done.
No, he's just done.
He's done twice. By done. He did himself in and his son did himself in, so it's called by done now.
There you go.
Anyways, you go down and say, okay, listen, you guys, and get the other guys in there, the Palestinians. Hamas. Yeah. I think they should go in the ham business. All they need is 45,000 square feet and 11 tons of ham. I've seen it. You make a fortune on the stock market. Hamas. You can market it, too. Whole world would probably buy, you know, better part of the world would buy it. Mm-hmm. You know, because they're getting the bad end of the squeeze here.
They are. Bad end of the squeeze.
And have sold for 70 years. So they lash out, you know, once in a while. But lies, just everything is lies.
Yeah.
Now, let me tell you. I never pick sides. Do I? Yes, I do. I pick sides.
You go back and forth, though.
I do. I give everybody a good chance. Now, just a second. Check to see if you're doing it right.
You usually.
Okay, so in other words, there I'm sitting with Netanyahu and say, do you know what you're doing here on this earth?
Mm-hmm.
And he goes, yeah, well, I'm descended from Noah and David and all that. And so I'm Hark the Herald Angel Singer, something like that.
Yeah.
No. You're trying to evolve. That doesn't negate your spirituality. That's a whole other question. But you're really trying to evolve. And does it really seem to you that massacring thousands and thousands of children is very evolutionary? Does that sound evolutionary? To a guy running a criminal welfare state? Yeah. Okay, that's enough.
Good.
I'm getting off that. What do you got now?
I was just going to make an observation about you and you picking sides. You usually pick a side and then switch when the other side becomes the underdog.
Well, I'm always on the underdog side, for sure. Yeah. But when you are sick, isn't knowing the big picture necessary to actually curing the illness?
Yes.
Well, that's exactly what we're talking about.
I know.
You're not curing it until you get into what I'm talking about.
I know. People don't like having to know things.
Now let's get going because we got to take a ride out to the cornfield of dreams where the old artists come out and request their songs and we got to get it done.
We're going to take a ride.
Time travel. Going to take a ride. I pass the honky tonk.
Pass the honky tonk.
Pass the county line.
Pass the county line.
Through the amber waves of grain.
Those waves of grain.
And pass a dairy cow.
With a big brown eye.
To the old cornfield of dreams.
Cornfield.
Only Molly can see these guys.
Cornfield of dreams.
It's like Kevin Costner's ball players, you know?
Cornfield of dreams. Cornfield of dreams.
Who's coming out today, Mom?
George Jones, Dad. Just because I asked a friend about her, she thinks I still care.
Okay, George, I'm going to show you how to sing this song.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to show. Yep, he's a funny old dude, that old George.
George.
They're all working the other side, but they're very, you know, they're doing a lot of stuff. They got a still inside the cornfield.
Yes.
Where they make the good corn liquor.
Yes.
Just like from Kentucky. Straight from, just like straight on down from Copper Road.
Copperhead Road. Yeah.
And they also got the other guy, you know, the guy down on Copper Road, he expanded his father's business because he went to Vietnam.
Vietnam.
Yeah. And he got some seeds down there. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. And so he got that going too. Kentucky. The Commonwealth of Kentucky. I think we should move there.
We'll get lucky in Kentucky.
Commonwealth shows the difference between peoples. You know, you can get a lot of people, a lot of rich people at the top. This is where America is going now. It's going to a developing nation.
Yeah.
Pushing all the money right on the top, just like a developing nation.
Yeah.
Your Commonwealth is pretty much gone.
Yeah.
All your mother's got to work.
Don't even get me started.
You know what I mean?
Oh, did you just give birth 2 weeks ago? When can you come into work?
There's a coup, Mom, and we gotta take it down. And what's the song? Who is it?
Because I asked a friend about her.
Who is it came out?
George Jones.
Oh, Joey. George. Geo.
Got the old timers dead.
Just go stay right here. I just wanted to say something. He's completely forgot about her, and he's just like in total dismay of why everybody thinks that, you know, he might be still thinking about her.
Yeah.
Just because I asked a friend about her. Just because I spoke her name somewhere. Just because I rang her number by mistake today.
By mistake.
She thinks I still care. Just because I haunt the same old places. Her memory of her lingers everywhere. Just because I ain't the happy guy I used to be. She thinks I still care. So if she's happy thinking I still need her, let that silly notion bring her cheer. Oh, how could she ever be so foolish? Oh, where would she get such an idea? Just because I haunt the same old places, where the memory of her lingers everywhere. Just because I saw her and went all to pieces, she thinks I still care.
Silly girl.
She thinks I still care. The silly girl.
Elvis also recorded it. John Fogerty and a million other people.
Yeah.
You don't even know about it. All they're going to know is they're going to think we sang it, you know, when we bring it back and make a huge hit out of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. What were you saying?
Remember that song? Girl, you'll be a woman soon. It's like this song that I think
was
really
big. Is that Righteous Brother? Righteous Brother?
No, it was like, I think it was from the Natural Born Killers soundtrack or something like that. It was on some big soundtrack. And I remember it was like, it feels like it was a huge song. But I feel like the world's forgotten it.
Oh, I know it. Yeah. I mean, I've heard it.
Girl, I love you so you much, you can't get on the way that I don't like it is. The boy is no good.
I thought it was really funny when Paul Anka, you know, procreation and survival are the evolution process.
Mm-hmm.
The creativity that you use, that you employ, solving all the puzzles, games, and stories in your survival and procreation
yeah.
is That's evolution. That's your brain evolving.
I've got a lot of that right now.
Yeah.
I'm trying to survive and procreate. Or at least keep the procreation surviving.
Good.
I got a lot of puzzles.
That's what we like to hear. Keep the whatever.
I'm talking about the children.
I know. The children.
The children.
Well, that's why this is what's so stupid about it. The oligarchs that have taken over. There's a coup.
Ollie.
There's a coup.
As we like to call them.
There's a coup in the United States. Because when you get all the main things that you need for a coup.
Yes.
When you control the media.
Yes.
When you control the money.
Yes.
When you control the military. Mm-hmm. You have got that country.
You've got it.
And there happens to be a small little piece of people that have got that now.
They've got it.
So, you know, kiss my grits. Well, it's
kiss
really complicated because they have to be ejected. They're developing nation brain function, and they're taking us from developing. Look at the stats. Check out any stats. Come on back and show me which ones are developed nation stats. Just the whole money is a developed nation stat, but it's all going whoop. It's a sucking sound to the top. Okay.
That's the sucking sound.
Used to be able to buy a house, buy a car. American dream. What about all that? Where'd that go?
Never happened. It was
happen.
It was all a dream.
It did happen, and some mothers saw it and went, oh, that's no good. You're giving too much money to those poor people.
There's a reason it never became...
We know how to get all that money,
listen,
too.
This is clever. There's a reason it never became called... It never got called the American reality.
Yeah. That's what Carlin used to say. It's called the American dream because that's what it is.
Oh,
it's
okay.
Just a dream.
He already did it.
Yeah, it's already been done. George Carlin did just about everything you could do.
All right, well, let's get out of the station. Get out to the station. Get back in the limo and
get on
that
because
old
of the girlies' toes.
Road.
All the girlies' toes get really hot.
Yeah.
Because they see all those old artists, you know, pretty exciting. And they're like, don't look like they're on their deathbeds.
No, they're in their heyday.
Yeah, they come back in their prime. You know, Johnny's pretty good. Johnny Cash, pretty good.
Yeah.
He was
not
thin.
Bad.
He was thin.
Not as good as Joaquin Phoenix.
Was he a country star?
He played Johnny Cash.
Oh, yeah, that guy. He's got a hair lip, doesn't he?
Well, it wasn't. He was born with it fixed up.
Yeah, well, it's...
It fixed itself in the womb.
Did it?
Yeah.
Really?
Apparently.
Wow. Hey, that's cool.
Yeah.
Don't say it in there.
All the girly toes.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, because all the girlies, too.
All the girly toes.
Are hanging out of the window.
They're hanging out of the window.
Somebody sees a great big tower, 50,000 watts, at station GHRT.
Station GHRT.
Is it for you and me?
Is it for you and me?
Brought to you by Alice's Restaurant and General
you
Store.
You can get anything you
anything
want.
Anything you want down at Alice's Restaurant. Alice's Restaurant. I'm going to pull in the old station and see if I can clear my throat. Go up to the front desk and see Betty Page in her cigarette girl uniform. Betty Page at 27. That's when she first started getting pictures taken.
Her heyday.
Yeah, everybody's in their heyday.
Yeah. It's prime time.
Because it's my show, and my hair looks like hay. I had a cousin always used to bug me. He said, your hair looks like hay. You know what I said?
Your hair looks like a pile of shit.
No, listen, you know what I said?
What?
Hey!
It's not a hey. It's hey!
Okay, I don't know what I'm singing, but...
We are pulling up to the station. There's Betty Page.
Oh, yeah, Betty Page. She's going to give you a special tea. Send you down the stairs here to the Broiler Room Studios with a psychedelic prairie home companion. The really big old-time radio medicine show, 3 Chords and the Truth, starring Molly Griffin and her old dog, Duke.
And the Reverend Dr. Joey G2 coming to you live from Station GHRT in the virtual haystack in your mind, where the show always starts in 5 minutes. And we don't spin the tunes on the turntable, we spin them on our souls. So kick back, chill out, and relax to the mellow sounds of the singing DJs.
Got the mellow sounds.
Very mellow.
Got those mellow sounds.
Mellow yellow.
And this ain't one of them, but we got the mellow sounds.
They're coming. The sound of one man panicking.
The biggest magic of this show is how ridiculous you are and make me laugh. And then everybody else starts laughing with me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
There you go.
One guy said he blew his coffee all over his computer, ruined his computer keypad.
you are your own studio audience.
Yeah, but you know, Ma, there's nothing funnier than the truth. The truth is, as bad as it may be, and it's some bad shit going on right now, mm-hmm. Yeah, but the worst.
Yeah.
The war, man. We love war.
War, sin, killing, and a robbing. It's a subtle war. If the world is one big problem, I got one, and I'll tell you now, I can't find my darn big cow.
Okay, that's the first time I tried it.
I do enjoy that song.
I need another chance. Okay. Let me say something heavy here. Well, that big pick that I was talking about. Remember I was talking about?
Yeah.
If you're sick, in order to really cure it.
You got to see the big pick.
You got to see the big picture. You got, like my dad, he died of esophageal cancer.
Yes.
But because they didn't see the big pick.
Yeah.
They had this miracle drug called, what was it called? The heartburn
shit. Zantac.
Zantac. And they wanted to push it so hard, they even took it away from the first doctors handed it out. Mm-hmm. Then they said, no, go ahead and take all you want.
Yeah.
Now, you put in on your computer, Zantac and esophageal cancer. This son of a bitch smoked cigarettes for like 1,000 years. Mm-hmm. No problem there. Zantac took him out with esophageal cancer.
Well, but he also had the, it was for the heartburn, right?
Yeah, he did have heartburn.
But heartburn means like a bunch of acid coming up your esophagus, and cancer is like acid. If you're too acidic, you get cancer. So what was causing the heartburn? We're just like house.
Yeah. But that's the point of the big picture, see? Mm-hmm. You're trying to cure. Yeah. You ask what was causing it. Mm-hmm. That's the big picture.
Yeah.
They weren't looking at what was causing it.
No.
They went, oh no, don't eat properly.
Yeah.
Get off the bacon and all the shit that's giving you the, you know, he loved everything greasy.
Yeah.
Duck.
Yeah.
Alaska black cod. Anything with a lot of grease in it, I almost like, I get nauseated watching him.
He was an oil man.
He was an oil man. But no big picture.
No big picture.
No, that's the way our health system is. Yeah. I got a drug for you.
Give it to me now.
My cousin Robin Williams, he said the day my doctor said, you know, that I had to take the stuff he was giving me to live, was the day he knew my doctor is a dealer.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes. Now, we have time for one quick song, Dad. We barely have time.
That big picture, I just want to say this, that big picture has been discovered and will replace self-preservation as the first law, natural law, and will change the paradigms of all disciplines of critical human thought. Because we know the impetus of the brain function is to evolve. Rock on, young Americans.
There you go.
What do you got?
I have got Losing You Might Be the Best Thing Yet.
Yeah, that's real good. Here?
Yeah.
Here's an old song about my third marriage. Straighten right up after I wrote her this song, Ma. Never went out again. There's no such thing as sleep for jealous fools. and being jealous about someone like you.
It's sort of.
Sort of foolish, too. You sure you got the right chord?
I don't know.
Oh, I want it, you want it, anyone you could get, losing you might be the best thing, yeah. Longest day I live, I still be suffering from shame in the gutter. You were making yourself quite a name. Oh, the life you chose is the one you want to get. Losing you might be the best thing yet.
Losing you might be the best thing yet.
Longest day I live, I still be suffering from the shame in the gutter. You were making yourself quite a name. Oh, I wanted you, and you wanted anyone you could get. Might be best thing yet. I said losing you might be the best thing yet.
Losing.
Yeah. You bad little baby. Okay, well now you know your life will never be the same if you stayed right until the end, because you know about the deep health. You know about the first law of nature is to evolve. So don't wait till you're old, and even if you are old. What is old anyway? I heard an 85-year-old guy, when the guy said, the old guy, he said, 85, not old. Whatever, you're never too old to understand that you're trying to evolve. That's what doing the crossword puzzle. But don't do crossword puzzles. Get some purpose and meaning. Do it serious. Get a project that has purpose and meaning. Deep health. That's what we're all about. Now listen. Get away from those swimming pools and movie stars. And get down here, because when you got your health, you got just about everything. You pee-picking hillbillies, you all come back.